right in front of us, right in the center of the cemetery. The reason I point this out is because it has a story attached to it that I'm going to tell you. See, this is the site of a strange event about 100 years ago, when two young boys from right here in town decided they were sick and tired of hearing all the ridiculous rumors surrounding us. They figured they could debunk all of those stories by spending a single night here in the Tolomato Cemetery, so they attempted to do so. They pitched their tent at the base of that center tree here amongst the gravestones and settled in for the night. But a few hours into their slumber, were awoken by an odd rustling noise coming from somewhere outside their tent. Now, they had told some of their friends from town what they were doing and figured someone just showed up to play a prank on them. But when they stepped outside to investigate, it was anything but. For before them stood, a ghostly woman, about a foot above the ground, and her back was turned to them. So they could see that she had gray hair that cascaded down her back in matted waves, and she wore an off-white gown that trailed long past her toes, pooling on the ground beneath her feet. The boys trembled in fear, and when she finally turned to face them, it was revealed that she had no face at all. Terrified, the boys bolted from the cemetery, never to return. And in the following days, spent all of their time asking the adults around them just what they had seen that night in the cemetery. And none of the answers they received were satisfactory until in the town square, one gentleman stepped forward and said ominously, "I know who you saw in the cemetery." He claimed that a century prior, a young woman in her prime, just 1 week before her wedding day, we have the brides to be, shame, had died suddenly of supposed heart weakness. Her grief-stricken family asked that the bride-to-be be buried in her wedding gown and veil as a final tribute to the ceremony that never was. And because they could not stand the sight of that gown and veil any longer, a reminder of their terrible dreams. This made perfect sense to the boys. She had that long white gown on, and that